If one earthquake has an MMS magnitude of 6.0 and another has a magnitude of 9, how much more powerful in terms of earth movement is the second earthquake? Okay, so we're working with the MMS or moment magnitude scale for earthquakes here, which is different than the Richter scale. The formula for the MMS scale is this, that the moment, M, which is the scale measure, is 2/3 times the log, and that's the common log, log base 10, of S over S0, where S is the earth movement of the earthquake, and S0 is a baseline measure. The value is about 10 to the 16th, but we don't actually need to know that for this problem. All right, so let's start out with that earthquake of magnitude 6. So since we know the magnitude is 6, we can plug in 6 for M for the magnitude and then solve for the amount of earth movement, which we're representing here with S1 because it's the first of the two earthquakes. So first step we're going to need to do is multiply both sides by 3/2. That will simplify on the left, and on the right, of course, it will simplify to just 1. So we'll have 9 equals log of S1 over S0. And now to finish solving for S1, we can rewrite this into its exponential form. So 10 to the 9th equals S1 over S0, so converting the log to an exponential. And then multiply by S0 to get S1 equals S0 times 10 to the 9th. In other words, this earthquake has 10 to the 9th times more earth movement than the baseline. Okay, and so there we have our first earthquake, and now we're going to repeat this process for the second. So we'll take that magnitude of 9 and plug it in for M, and then do the same solving process we did in the last one. And we end up with the earth movement here, S2, is the baseline S0 times 10 to the 13.5. Okay, so this is a more earth movement, of course, than the first earthquake. So to compare the two, we're going to look at the ratio of S2 to S1. So this will tell us how many times more powerful the second earthquake was than the first. So we'll take those values that we just found for S2 and S1, and we'll find the ratio of the two. And you'll notice that the S0 term is going to cancel. And so we end up with just 10 to the 13.5 over 10 to the 9th. And that's why I said it doesn't actually matter what the baseline measure is here, because we're looking at the ratio of these two quantities. And now we can simplify this. So when we divide things of like base, we can subtract the exponents, and we end up with 10 to the 4.5 or as a decimal value, about 31,622.78. So what does this tell us? This tells us that the second earthquake produced about 31,623 times more earth movement than the first earthquake did. So it gives us some idea how much more powerful that second earthquake was.